idiots. The power strip wasn't in. Oh my god. All right, we are.
I was
now
like worrying
live.
About the camera, like trying to fix them, and I was like, "Oh, is it not plugged in?"
Yeah, that might be my fault, but oh well.
You were the one who got the power strip out.
Fair point.
Why was it off?
I don't know. Don't you switch your power strip? But anyway, we are now live. Max is about to throw the first pitch, and it's foul ball. It is senior night here at Nick Dennis Field, our AKA Corey Hart Ballpark Western campus.
Hey, Tucker, who are the four seniors for Greenwood tonight?
Well, the four seniors would be our starting pitcher, Mac Osbrooks. Oh, another foul ball.
No one's going to hit somebody.
Then we have our first baseman, Drew Lors. And then we also have our left fielder, Tyler Cook, as well as Chandler Wilson, our right fielder tonight. All four seniors are starting tonight. Good move by Coach Jaggers, unlike the now relief of his position, Coach Bob Pels.
Come on.
What?
You don't got to call out our mans like that, Tucker.
Our man's Bob Pels? The one who is... Who is no longer employed at Greenwood High School?
He was actually a fan of our broadcast, though, Tucker.
Okay.
Showed it to one. Showed it like in like two film sessions.
He also called us rec league bums. Ooh.
Well, we kind of are rec league bums.
Fair point.
But guys, this is our final broadcast. So I mean, we're probably only gonna have like four viewers. So it's not like it really matters. But ooh, two viewers. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Yeah.
But up here, we're the Three Musketeers. It's me, yeah. Tucker, and Ian Shimizu up here. It's kind of a chilly day today, though.
Yeah, this is a little bit of a chill. I walked outside this morning in shorts and t-shirt and immediately walked back in to change because it's about 55 degrees outside. Oh, that's a four-pitch walk for Mac Osbrooks after recording the first
That last
out.
Pitch looked a little...
I looked like it was in.
Yeah, but I mean, we do not criticize the refs.
When have we ever criticized our KHSAA employees?
Or umps. I always get, do you ever make that mistake where you call umpires referees?
I used to.
Do you not anymore?
No, it's one of my major pet peeves.
Who's up to bat now for Cumberland County?
That would be number, hang on.
That would be Hunter Perdue, the designated hitter. He's a big boy, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Okay, the zero is on the line. I apologize. The lineup cards for Cumberland County were apparently written in some form of chicken scratch in Arabic.
What's the difference?
Of course, that shouldn't have an effect on the numbers, considering... English users use Arabic numbers.
We might have a post-game interview with Mr. Dillingham after this, by the way. Hmm. We talked to him about that, so might be a possibility.
Sounds interesting. Here's the 0-1 pitch coming in.
Dawson Smith has taken a very generous lead off of first right there.
Ooh. Ooh, nice sinker right there.
Did you know that the starting pitcher right now, Mac Osbrooks, has actually gotten a full scholarship offer from NTSU?
Yes, we have mentioned that on our last stream.
Mm-hmm.
I was the one who told you that. It's also being scouted by Western Kentucky at this point.
Which would you choose, Tucker?
I would go with the, I mean, honestly, NTSU doesn't have that good of a baseball facility, and Western's was just upgraded, and it's the hometown school.
So now up to bat is Curtis Akeley, the first baseman for Cumberland County. He's a big guy, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Probably has a lot of power. Ooh.
He just got plunked.
One pitch.
I think Mac is just thinking too hard right now.
Yeah. He's had a lot of those so far.
But he still has a no-hitter bid, so.
No longer a perfect game, though.
Drew Lohr's kind of going over there, giving him a talk. Maybe trying to calm his jitters there a little bit. Now up to bat will be Cameron Patterson, the right fielder for Cumberland County. Ooh.
Got him that time.
Blow it by him right there. The old heater.
It's a really slow swing almost. Or maybe it was just such a fast
pitch. I just
don't
think he was expecting that that velocity on that pitch.
Probably expecting off speed, as that's what he's gone for most of these first pitches so far.
Be a real low pitch there, called for strike two. So now the count will be 0-2. No balls, two strikes, two outs, two on.
Mac takes a good long look at his catcher, Delhing.
Good.
Throw it in, and that'll be strike three. Way to recover.
Yeah.
And he'll get out of the inning without any runs.
Gave up two base runners right there and then just waved the fourth batter there in three pitches. Good piece of pitching there by Mac Osbrooks. Sorry for the technical
difficulty. All right, looks like they have their PA system working again. That was a major issue before we got this stream going.
Yeah. It's not like Charlie Brown's teacher.
Yes.
If you want a representation of what it sounded like, it was like this.
Yeah. It's like the Charlie Brown's teacher is actually a direct quote from our PA announcer, except we had to change it a little bit.
For obvious reasons.
Yes. Warming up on the mound right now would be number 8, Colby Huddleston, who's also batting leadoff.
You don't see that very often, do you?
No, you don't.
They also have a pretty small catcher, don't they?
Yeah. Not very built.
Pretty sure this is the first matchup of the season between Cumberland County and Greenwood, if I'm not mistaken.
Well, they are pretty far away. You wouldn't think they'd had too many meetings. They're actually farther east than Glasgow, about 2 hours from here. So they've got a long bus ride home.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully it'll be an even longer bus home with a loss, because we're rooting for our Greenwood Gators on senior night tonight. I'm sure Cumberland County really doesn't care, though. They're just going to be trying to get the win in this one. You know how the Reds have recently been experimenting with Joey Votto at leadoff?
Yes.
The Greenwood should try Drew Lohr's at leadoff. What do you think about that, Tucker?
I guess just for the speed. I'm not quite sure how else that would really work.
And with the pitch, I'll be outside for the first pitch. And what does Martin Brudeman say?
Marty Brennan, other than Reds, and this one belongs to the Reds.
Yeah, he says something at the beginning, doesn't he?
Not usually, I don't think.
I thought. Oh, well. So that'll be three straight outside
three
pitches to make
balls.
It 3-0. Don't interrupt me, Tucker. If you're just joining us, the score is currently 0-0. Cade Thornton is up to bat, and it'll be a 3-1 count. And tonight is Greenwood Gators senior night. So, and also it's kind of me and Tucker's senior night, being that this will be our last ever broadcast that we have. Also joined by the already graduated Dean Chimizu, who just hated the early mornings.
Oh, that's a pop-up, and we'll probably be the first out.
Well, that catcher has some interesting hairdo, doesn't he?
Yeah, Actually, yeah, I didn't catch it.
It's like bleach blonde.
Yeah.
How does the infield fly rule work, Tucker?
Infield fly rule. It's very complicated.
Something that I'm really confused by.
It's typically used whenever there are base runners on. It's so the fielder won't intentionally try to drop it to hopefully try to get a double play in the infield. It actually messed up the I think it was the Braves in the 2012 wild card game. Of course, the inaugural year the wild card was used for two teams. But, of course, it was a winner-take-all game, but bases were loaded around the top of the seventh, and there was a pop fly hit straight up, and then the opposing team dropped the ball, but they called infield fly rule, which ended the inning, even though multiple base runners scored. Or no, there was only one out. That's why they called infield fly rule.
Huh.
But multiple base runners would have scored.
There'll be another foul ball right behind the plate.
Whoa! That was close. That landed very close to our camera.
That was real funny. But now up to bat will be Dale Hink, the catcher for Greenwood.
Ooh.
Batting second. And the count will be 1-2.
Decent piece of hitting right there, and that's going to drop. Real good move right there by Dell to get out over the plate and just knock it straight over the infielders.
I have a question. Do you like how wooden bats sound, or do you like how aluminum bats sounds more?
I think both sound good, but you can never get over the sound of the good old crack of the bat of a wooden bat. Interesting walk-up music choice by Mac Osbritz. Some outcast. I can appreciate that.
And be an outside pitch.
A pitch out, and they still didn't get him.
That will be Reed Sloan, by the way, as the courtesy runner. But that outside pitch will make it 1-0 now for Mac Osbritz. And the score is still at 0-0.
Ooh, he really jumped on that one. And it's going to send their left fielder back, but he's going to be able to make the catch.
I thought that one might have had a chance to go yard.
Yeah, he got a little bit more on.
Kind of had a lot of pop coming off the bat, but to no avail. So that will be the second out, and Braxton Garner, the four batter, will be up to bat now.
Next up for the Gators, the designated hitter, number 36, Braxton Garner.
Did you hear about that New York softball pitcher, Tucker?
No, I didn't.
The one who struck out 21 batters in a row for a perfect game.
Is this professional softball?
No, this is high school softball.
Okay.
So there goes somebody's windshield on that foul ball.
That did go right over the street.
That'll be a whiff.
Right by him right there.
Whiff.
I know they haven't really been able to get too many base runners, but I do like the contact that Greenwood's making on these pitches so far.
Mm-hmm.
Almost reminds me of the game against Warren East earlier this year. They're always getting contact, but ooh, nice shot by Braxton Garner. Ah, that's going to go just foul. He jumps on that a little more. That might be gone.
How many more foul balls do you think they can stand to lose until they have none left?
I mean, they seem to be running them down pretty well. Just hopefully none of them end up in the press box or on our camera.
That'd be pretty funny, though. Could it get fouled in like such a trajectory it would actually land in here?
It could. It'd be really like difficult, though. I don't know. I get a D in physics. Oh, that's another ball.
Attempted an off-speed and failed, so that will make it...
The infield umpire called a balk on that one.
Oh, very interesting.
He got started and then stopped.
Do balks get accounted to errors?
They do not. I think they're their own category. Ooh. Hard shot right there by Braxton Garner, but right at the second baseman, Dawson Smith. Apologize, fans. Jackson just took our lineup card and aggressively slammed it on the table.
You're good.
I get up.
Jet. Is this Jet by Paul McCartney? Should have told her to take a video of that.
Apologize, fans. We're just
This is Jump. I'm an idiot.
Yes, I was about to say.
This is Def Leppard, right? Yeah.
I don't think this is Def Leppard.
Yeah, this is definitely Def Leppard. Definitely. This has to be Def Leppard.
Doesn't remote, except for the lead singer, this doesn't really remotely sound like a Def Leppard song, though. It's Van Halen.
What? Huh. I get Van Halen and Def Leppard confused a lot, though.
Yeah.
Like, I thought Panama was by Def Leppard, but it's actually by Van Halen.
Wait, Panama's not by Def Leppard?
No, it's by Van Halen.
Oh, well,
yeah, exactly.
I can no longer name three Def Leppard songs, then. Because that was one of them.
I can name three Van Halen. Can you name three Van Halen songs?
Eruption, Jump, and Panama, because we discussed the last two.
So that will be two outside pitches there in a row to make the count 2-0. And up to bat now for Cumberland County will be number 25, Briley Sewell, the catcher. Sewell.
Ooh, that ball danced.
So like count 2-1.
Looked like it was going outside in the last second and cut right back in over the plate. Ooh, you jumped on that one. But it's going to be easily handled there by
Tyler
Cook.
He's the other southpaw accompanying Kate Thornton in the outfield right now. The two southpaws on this team.
Actually, all three of them are left-handed.
Oh, yeah, I forgot Chandler Wilson. Too.
Probably doesn't happen too often.
So that'll be a real inside pitch there for make the count 0-1. Or 1-0, sorry. Did you know Martin Brenneman is actually retiring after the season?
Yes, I did know that. He's been at it for 45 years.
Mm-hmm. He's been here for the...
A whole lot of Reds losing.
He's been here for the great, the good, the bad, and the terrible. So.
Hopefully his last year can be pretty good. Looks like they've started to have a bit of an upward trend.
Hopefully. Well, it has been against the San Francisco Giants.
Right.
And everybody has an upward trend against the San Francisco Giants.
Tell that to the 14 games that they...
You okay, Tucker?
Stop. I was about to say 14 teams that beat them. It was not 14 individual teams that they beat. It was likely the same team multiple times.
San Francisco Giants are one of those teams that you kind of like hope to fatten up on, like Warren Central. Where you just kind of come in, clobber them, and then pad your stats a little bit and your record. Mm.
That one got him inside a little bit. And that'll be two outs. Good fielding by Wesley Flowers.
Easy way to get out of that full count right there by Mike Osbrooks. So now up to bat will be Isaiah Dyer, the center fielder for Cumberland County.
Side for ball one.
Jump.
Ooh, nice shot. That's gonna go out past Tyler Cook.
Be a nice
this could be
hit
three.
There.
Ooh, he ran his helmet straight off.
But they will hold him there, so that will be a double attributed to Isaiah Dyer there. That was a nice pull hit there by him. Yes. Allowed him to get extra bases. Where is Dell playing? Oh, Dell's playing catcher.
That's why Braxton's lined up at DH for this game. Ooh.
Dell and Lance kind of trade that catcher third baseman position quite a bit, don't they?
Yes. Oh, that could have been very bad.
Nah. Got Cade Thornton holding it down out there. They have nothing to worry.
It's a good heads-up play by him. That could have gone bad quickly, though.
That was a very weird pickoff move there from Mac, though. So that'll be a pop fly on the 1-0 count, and that will be reeled in by Wesley Flowers.
It's going to end the inning.
Mm-hmm.
She's watching in the stream.
Nice. Yeah. Very nice.
That's how she knew that.
Thank you all for tuning in, by the way. Just wanted to give a quick thank you as we go into the bottom of the second. This will be our last ever broadcast, so just thanks for tuning in. We love all of you. Currently, Greenwood is actually 17-10 on the season. That's extremely. Oh my God, Tucker. That's extremely good. But as we were talking about Wesley Flowers actually was on the mound in Greenwood's last game against Metcalf County. Wasn't his strongest game. He gave up 5 runs on 6 hits in 2.1 innings, but. Not very many of the pitchers actually fared very well. Wesley Flowers didn't do too well. Braxton Garner also failed to do very well, giving up 4 runs in 0.2 innings. So hopefully it will be a stronger performance here by the Greenwood bullpen today. Although we know Wesley Flowers has all the talent in the world. Sounds sarcastic, but that wasn't. We love you, Wesley.
Is this Nas? I like the walk-up choices for our Greenwood seniors.
But now up to bat will be Chandler Wilson, the right fielder. He's batting in the 5th slot today. Be a real high and outside pitch there by Colby Huddleston. Sorry, folks, didn't mean to cough to my mic there.
Gonna be strike one. Of course, with pitches like those, you don't really want to swing at them if you don't have a strike already.
Mm-hmm.
It's really hard to get a good piece of hitting out of the lower half of the zone.
So the count is now 1-2 after that chopper.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. And he fouls it all the way out.
That may hit somebody in the parking lot. So the count will remain 1-2 after that foul ball. What are you expecting from this game today, Tucker?
I'm going to be quite honest. I don't know too much about this opponent. So
you don't got to say that every time, Tucker. So just bullcrap it. Come on, man.
I don't say that every time. Sometimes
yes, you do.
Stuff, but,
last time we played against Butler County, you were like, yeah, we all know we keep up Butler County.
Well, they look like a pretty formidable opponent, so I like to see a good game. Some so far the pitching hasn't been all too well, so probably a lot of runs scored, and hopefully the Gators win.
See, that's that brutal analysis I'm looking for,
yeah.
Tucker.
Just like this brutal walk-up music from Outkast to Nas to Will Smith.
So now Lance Upright up to bat, the current boyfriend of Chapel Volker. I just got to let the viewers know, Tucker. They have the right to know.
I don't think they do. We're not Woodward and Bernstein. We are Greenwood TV.
They didn't even know they needed it, but they did.
This is not Watergate. This is high school relationships.
But the Greenwood team so far has been rocking some pink gloves today. Maybe representing for the for all the Mother's Day mothers out there.
Yes, they didn't wear their breast cancer awareness uniforms on Saturday. They look quite fresh.
Freaky fresh. All right, now the count is 2-1 now for Lance Upright. He's rocking those New Balances. I really like those. I actually have that exact same pair of turfs.
I'm a big fan of New Balance cleats.
Didn't you say you were more of an Easton guy, though?
I mean, that was the pair I wore. But I prefer New Balance.
That'll be a real high strike there to make it a full count.
It's got to be tough there for Lance. Thinking you're heading on to first, but now you got to step back into the box and collect yourself. And that's going to land just foul, or not just foul.
It's going to take out some of the mothers at the senior day little pavilion over there.
Yeah. There's a nice little setup there. They got balloons, picnic tables.
Quite nice.
And that's going to be ball four, hopefully.
Well, Lance Upright, when he's able to get some wood on it, though, you're looking at that thing to hit the wall in some situations. Now up to bat, the defensive stalwart and the most attractive man on the entire Greenwood roster, Drew Lores.
Yes, sir. All 5'8 of him, according to KHSAA.
When in reality he's about 6'4", but he's 6'4".
Maybe.
He's 6 feet and 4 inches worth of love.
Maybe he's the opposite of Louis Hubert. He's 6'4", but when he stands on his money, he's 5'8".
So that foul ball there.
He's severely in debt.
So that foul will make it strike one for Drew Lore, so the count will be 1-1. One ball, one strike, one out.
Oh.
The ump kind of pondered that one for a little while, didn't he?
Yep. Typically, you see an instantaneous call if it's going to be a strike, but you wait until Drew is already stepping out of the box.
I think that ump likes to leave you in suspense. So the count is 2-2.
That's
going to
be another stolen base. Woo, that was really close.
He almost got domed on that one.
Well, on the bright side, it would have been a free base.
So that will make the count now 2-2. Drew Lore is kind of pushing up in the batter's box, and he will strike out. He's kind of swinging for the fences on those. He's got to kind of tone it back. Now up to bat will be the other resident senior, Tyler Cook, the left fielder for Greenwood.
Let's hope his at-bat is a little bit better than his walk-up music. Played some Florida Georgia Line, who in my opinion is the Nickelback of country.
Spider. Start throwing stuff. All right, that foul ball will make it a 1-1 count now. And we just want to give a quick thank you to our resident scoreboard keeper, Ian Shimizu. We love him.
That's going to be another free base for Lance Upright. We've got a runner on third now.
Mm-hmm.
There are two outs.
Hopefully Tyler Cook just kind of like chokes up in that bat, pushes up a little bit in that batter's box and kind of drives in a run now to kind of to break this gridlock right now. Or the stalemate, I mean.
I mean, I would say both words work in that situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Here's the 2-1 pitch. And it's going to be ball three.
That was in the, another time zone on that pitch.
As he. Lance has really been able to get in this pitcher's head. He's making him adjust his windup and everything to try to pick him off. And it's making him miss a lot.
That will be a walk there for Tyler Cook. So now there will be runners in the corners. Tyler Cook at first and Lance Upright at third.
Now
and with Ethan Gregory up to bat.
Gregory. Catcher doing some complicated signs. Wasn't quite sure if he was just dancing to the music or making signs right there.
Oh. So that will be a foul ball off the net there for a 0-1 count. Ethan Gregory, the resident junior, actually.
Quite a few juniors on this roster, actually.
Mm-hmm. Next year, they'll have to bring out the pavilion or the gazebo to be able to present all of their helmets.
Yeah. Hopefully, anyway, you hope nobody decides to quit.
Actually, there were three players who quit.
Yeah.
From during that transition from junior to senior with Titus Thornhill, Connor Klein, and Matthew Rogers all leaving the team through the summer. But we wish them the best.
I did think it was a good job by Coach Jaggers to work with what he had after losing three senior leaders.
He definitely did fill those holes very adequately, though, with some very young but promising players. I don't know what that was.
That was an attempt to get Lance to jump on it because, as you know, with runners on the corners, you always want to try to steal second base, maybe try to psych the pitcher out into throwing over there and getting an easy run in.
Tyler Cook was kind of sidestepping there on that one, wasn't he? So after that ball, it will be an even count now with 2-2.
What you wanted to do in that situation, though, is if you were to throw it to second, just get yourself in a pickle and get that run across the plate.
So that will be an outside pitch for a full count? Sorry.
Because so long as the runner on third crosses the plate before you get tagged, it does count.
Yeah. But Lance Upright is not the quickest guy on the team.
Well, you'd think that Tyler would be able to last it out.
But
and
that will be
that's going to be a run scored. Oh, they're going to try to score another one, and it goes straight over the catcher. That's going to be a good old.
So that'll be a little league double there by Ethan Gregory, and that will be two RBIs.
Let's
so
see if they attribute that as an error.
Oh, that'll definitely be an error. But that will be a that will make the score now 2-0 with Cade Thornton up to bat for Greenwood, with Ethan Gregory at second base.
Probably a stat keeper, I'd attribute that as a single and then an error that has him reaching second.
Yeah, yeah.
That is two RBIs to his name, though. That part won't change. And I'm sure that's all he cares about.
Good piece of hitting there, hit by him,
ooh,
though, right down the middle.
Hard hit ball, but it's probably going to be caught for at number three.
Mm-hmm.
He had to trail quite a bit, though, to catch that.
So Cade Thornton will be retired, and that will be Greenwood getting out of the inning now, and we'll be in the top of the third. Was a pretty costly inning there for Cumberland County, though, giving up two runs on one hit right there. So hopefully they will be to hopefully they'll be able to recover and make this a more competitive game. Hey, we were listening to this before we got here.
Oh yeah, we were.
Rock and
it's
roll
crazy.
By Led Zeppelin. It's almost like it's a really popular song. Whoa. Hey, Adam. Hey, Adam. We got retweeted by GHS Or Club. We got retweeted by GHS Or Club. We're big.
Big.
Yeah.
Yeah. So just had three people watching, though.
We love them all, though.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure one of them is my dad, one of them is your mom, and then there's probably another parent watching this. By the way, folks, sorry we weren't able to film the senior night proceedings. It was just that the mic was having a few problems in the background, so we hope that we hope to make up with that with a good broadcast now through this game. Sadly, we won't be able to join you for the postseason, though, because KHSAA wants us to pay $500 as students to be able to film the playoffs. But boy! Mac Osworth has really been trying to ride that inside corner with that off-speed pitch, but hopefully he doesn't hit any more batters. He already hit one in the first inning, so hopefully he's able to get more control on that. But riding that inside corner has really been profitable for him through this season.
He's able to set up the outside of the plate right there, though. Mm-hmm. A good pitch.
Mac Osworth has amazing ball placement, honestly. That's probably he's probably has the strongest ball placement out of this entire Greenwood rotation.
Of course, that's just on his fastballs, though. If he has any pitch with movement, he'll sometimes have a little bit of difficulty, as he has today.
She's with another man. So that will be a grounder to third, but that will be reeled in by Lance Upright. That'll be a good job by Drew to field that one, prevent the error. So that will be a single there for, I think that was Deacon Duval. No, that will be Colby Huddleston, the pitcher for Cumberland County. So Dawson Smith, the second baseman for Cumberland County, will now be up to bat, number five for them.
That's going to be flown straight up, hopefully for out number one. Called by Lance up right there. That'll be out number one. It's always good to get that first out whenever you have a runner on with no outs, because that situation can turn south pretty quick.
Mm-hmm. So, Drew, Tucker, you were telling me earlier about what Drew Lore said about South Warren. What did he have to say about them?
He said that they were really the only team that they needed to, that they felt like they needed to beat to reach region. Mm-hmm. As, you know, it's already pretty well a known fact that they can beat both Central and East. Mm-hmm. And as both the runner-up and winner get to go to region, you really only need to beat one team. In that case, it'll be a South Warren, and they recently dropped a series to Allen County Scottsville, who's only 9-23 on the season.
Mm. Yeah, well,
that is
baseball is any man's sport, though. That's why you very rarely see repeat World Series champions. I think the last World Series champion to repeat was the 1999-2000 Yankees, correct?
Yes, because the Dodgers were the last team to even make the World Series 2 years in a row.
Mm-hmm.
For a while.
And baseball is any man's sport.
But it doesn't look too good whenever you drop a series to a 9-win team.
Yeah, I understand that. But there will be a walk there for Mac Osbrooks, and there will be a conference meeting on the mound. Do you think Coach Eggers is going to pull Mac in this situation?
They've already taken the ball out of his hands. I don't know if they're going to switch him out just yet. We haven't really seen any action in the bullpen.
Mm. Oh, wait. No, they'll leave Mac out there. It is senior night after all, so maybe they're hoping to just let him let him deal this one until he can't throw no more.
And you don't want to pull your starter too early, because then you have to get deep into your bullpen when it's only the top of the third. So I got another 2/3 of the game to go.
Oh, now up to bat for Cumberland County will be Curtis Akeley, the first baseman for Cumberland County. And he shows the bunt, but it will be inside for ball one. And also a real quick thank you to Mr. Dillingham. Our STLP teacher has really been the philanthropist behind this entire thing and helping to fund and just support this entire program we've had. Being the first high school broadcast in Warren County, and perhaps maybe Kentucky, like we stated earlier.
I mean, I don't think there's any other schools that live stream their sports. We could be the first.
That would actually be really cool.
Yes, that would be. That's three straight balls right there. Mac. You have to think he would try to throw low here, not inside. Maybe try to make him chase on a bunt.
Mm-hmm.
Have a dribbler that gets quickly handled with. That's going to be ball one. Did exactly what I said. Called it.
So that will make the count 3-1 now for my crosswalk. Score currently is 2-0 in favor of your Greenwood Gators after a 2-RBI shot by Ethan Gregory.
Well, it wasn't really a shot. It was more of a chopper.
Well, and they just called a balk on Mac Osbrooks.
Oh.
And he seems pretty disgruntled about it.
It's been the second balk so far in this game.
I don't know. I've always kind of questioned the authenticity of balk calls, because it's really just kind of like the ref.
Yes.
I don't know. It's just
most of the time, it's just technically a balk. It's not actually fake throwing the ball.
Yeah.
And that's going to be ball four. And now the bases are juiced with only one out. This could get ugly pretty quick.
Mm-hmm. But in a nod of confidence to Mac Osbrooks, Coach Jaggers will leave him in for maybe the remainder of this inning. And right now up to bat will be Cameron Patterson, the right fielder for Cumberland County. After he fouls it off towards the Greenwood dugout, first strike one. So if you're Cameron Patterson, what's your mindset right now, Tucker? Bring the hands in, choke up on the bat a little bit?
I'm not quite sure. I'd have to know more about him as a hitter. Looks like he'd be more of a power type hitter.
Well, if you were in this situation.
If I were in the situation, I'd just be looking to shoot a gap, get a runner across, and get on base safely, because there is one out. If there were no outs, I would try to hit as hard as I could.
Yeah.
And this could be double play material right here. And
it
is.
Be.
And we're going to get out of this inning with no runs. Good piece of fielding right there by Lance Upright.
That was a great great third base move there by Lance Upright. That is kind of deflating for you as a batter, though.
Yeah.
Whenever you're in that great situation with full bases and only one out, and then you don't come out of
really
it with anything.
That's really got to hurt for Cumberland County. Mm. You had a runner on with no outs, and the bases loaded with only one, and then you come away with nothing.
Tucker, I have a question. Since this is your last broadcast, what are you going to do from now on, Tucker? Drew Lores is actually running towards the bullpen right now.
Yeah, he's warming up.
Perhaps we may see a relief pitch performance from the Greek demigod himself, Drew Lores.
Could just be Coach Jaggers wanting him to limber up for later on in the game.
Mm.
Sometimes you will see pitchers warm up in the bullpen several innings before they're actually slated to pitch.
Yeah.
Just in case you need to bring him in a little earlier.
But what are you doing after this, Tucker?
After we're done broadcasting?
No, after like this year in high school.
I'm heading off to UK, studying medical lab science, and I'll just see where that takes me.
Very nice.
Where are you heading off, Jackson?
WKU, actually. Yeah. Think I'm going there straight out of the gates, so that should be fun.
Have you decided on a major yet?
Nope.
Hmm. try your interests.
I'm actually doing a little summer program with WKU, so hopefully that'll help me narrow down my results. But classes in the summer are much, much cheaper than they are in the normal school year.
It's a good idea to get started on that early. You plan on living on campus?
Well, for summer, I actually will. I'm basically forced to live on campus against my will. But then I'm not quite sure after. So now up to bat will be Dell Hink, the catcher for Greenwood.
And that ball is going to go foul. Is it catchable? No, it is not.
As it kills somebody in the stands over there.
Actually landed on the building behind the baseball facility. Here's the 1-1 pitch. It's going to be outside for ball two.
Hey, Tucker, do you want to hear a joke?
Sure.
All right. Actually, that one's probably too long for a baseball broadcast. Yep. Should save it for later.
All right.
Not screwed. I'll say it. So this moth, right? It's like a Saturday night, and he goes into a podiatrist's office, right? Goes into a podiatrist's office.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Del Hink just got domed. Took a good long look at the pitcher after taking off his helmet.
I think that was a situation where he wanted to charge the mound.
Ah, yes.
He got clunked on that one. And a courtesy runner, Reed Sloan, will be in now at first.
Based on the differences in build, that would probably be a very short fight.
Yeah.
Del Hink is the winner.
And now up to bat will be the other senior, Mac Osbrooks, the current girlfriend of nobody. Ladies, he's single. Even though most of the people watching this podcast are retirement age.
All right.
All right.
How many people do we have on this broadcast now?
Not enough, am I right?
We have three watching.
Nice.
Going to be taken outside for ball two. Looks like Colby Huddleston has had a little bit of struggles with ball placement so far in this inning.
Mm-hmm.
Hasn't really been able to establish anything over the plate so far.
But the count will be at 2-0 now, and after that low pitch it will be 3-0. But the mouth goes into a podiatrist's office on a Saturday night, and he goes in, he's talking to a podiatrist, and he says, yeah, I don't know what it is recently, but I've been real down. My my boss at work, he's been asking me to come in early and leave late, and I've been working long hours, and I haven't gotten a pay raise in a while, and my job title has always stayed the same. I just don't know what I'm gonna do, man. And his name is Mr. Ilgofsky, and he's a real mean guy, and I'm just hoping for the best out of him. Says, yeah, and then my daughter, she's another story. She's been
Ooh, nice shot there by Mac Osbrooks.
So we'll advance the runners, and there will be batters at first and second with Braxton Garner, the absolute unit, up to bat with no outs.
Zero.
But he was talking. He said, "Yeah, my daughter, she hasn't been really talking to my mom or to her mom or." To me, she's been really just kind of cutting herself off from us, and I'm really concerned about her. My son, he's been going to parties. He's been associating himself with the wrong group. I mean, it's been really, really concerning in my household. And, I mean, my wife, me and her have been getting into constant fights, and I just don't know what's going to happen with between us. Moth was just sitting there, and he was real bummed out. The podiatrist looked at him. He was like, man, that's some really deep stuff. But you should be seeing a psychiatrist about this. Why are you here? Why are you at a podiatrist's office? And he says, ah, because the light was on.
I had a feeling that was going to be a joke about a light.
So that outside pitch will make it a 3-0 count now for Braxton Garner.
This inning could get really bad really quick.
Or really good run. Really quick for Greenwood.
Yeah, it's going to be really bad for Colby Huddleston, though.
Yeah.
So he'd have the one more ball means the bases are juiced with no outs, and you've got Chandler Wilson up to bat next.
Yeah. Well, that pitch kind of corrected it right there, making it a 3-1 count.
Ooh. Nice shot downfield. Is that going to drop? No, it was a nice over-the-shoulder catch there by the left fielder, Garrison Bean. He was really off the bean on that catch.
Next up for the Gators.
Now Chandler Wilson up to bat.
Guess you could say Braxton got beaned on that one. I'm going to take that look of disapproval as a laugh.
My joke was better.
And that's going to be a single right there, and that's probably going to be a run scored. Uh-oh, they're running it in. And Chandler Wilson gets greedy and knocks him off the base.
Oh. He'll call Chandler Wilson out.
That's a very suspicious call, to say the least.
Well, it looked like he did have him his foot tagged before he got to the base, though. So.
But he was knocked straight off of the base. Looked like he lost control of the ball.
I feel like there was criticism either way it was called.
Yes.
All right, well, now up to bat will be Lance Upright.
Two outs. Another runner scored right there.
The current boyfriend of Chapel Volkert.
You announced that.
As far as I know.
Last
hopefully bad. Nothing tragic has happened between them. Mm. That'd be really awkward.
A 3-0 count really quick right there.
There actually are some WKU players here in attendance watching this tonight, there right in front of us.
Huh.
Not a large number. There's about three of them, but they're still here.
Hmm. Of course, as some of you all may know, Jake Sanford, is current WKU baseball player, is actually leading the Conference USA in the Triple Crown. He has the highest batting average, most home runs, and most RBIs.
Mm-hmm. Well, that will make it a full count now for Lance Upright. He's got a runner on third, so hopefully he's trying to just bring this runner in and get on base. And that'll do it.
That's going to do it. It's going to be another run scored. It's going to make it 4-0 for your Gators.
So that will be J.D. Hunt across the base there.
And we've got a meeting at the mound.
Yeah, you could kind of tell this one was coming.
Yeah, he's really started to lose control of his ball placement.
Yeah. Well, now up to bat will be Drew Lohrs. The fan favorite here.
Yeah.
Oh, and he will leave Colby Huddleston out.
Right.
As a kind of nod of confidence towards him. Hopefully he's just hoping that he'll be able to clean it up. He has already pitched 71 times, and it's only in the bottom of the third inning. So hopefully he's able to break out of this little rut he's in.
Well, it is early in the week. He could be looking to save some of the arms in his bullpen. Mm-hmm. Ooh, another hit for Drew. Or actually, it's his first hit of the game, but it's another hit for the Gators.
Yeah. So now he will be on base, accompanying Lance Upright on first and second. And with Tyler Cook now up to bat, hopefully he's hoping to bring in one of these runs and pad onto this four-run lead that Greenwood has accrued.
Ooh, that one almost, it was almost the second doming.
That was a very curvy curveball right there.
Almost had a Pirates Red situation right there.
Oh, I don't think there's enough bad. I don't think there's any bad blood in between Cumberland County and Greenwood. We're a little bit too far away for that.
Ooh, that's a tough strike call for strike one.
So we'll make it an even count, 1-1 now.
That was a good take though by Tyler. You don't want to try to chase outside the zone too much. And Lance Upright tries to steal third, and he's going to make it.
And that will be a double steal, actually, with Lance Upright and Drew Lohrs both stealing their respective bags.
I'm not
I guess
quite
you could
sure.
say they're chasing the bag.
Yes, they got the bag. They got the bag, and they ran with it. That's going to be ball two.
So that will be an even count now. Two balls, two strikes, two on.
And two out, 22-22, also known as 10-22 in military time.
Wait, I think it's my mom, your mom, and my dad, who are the only ones who are watching us right now.
Huh. Fine.
Hopefully we'll have a bigger audience next season when Eli Lovell is actually the commentator for us. So that will fill the bases now after that walk.
Hopefully we see another good piece of hitting here from Ethan Gregory.
But that will be a real high pitch above Ethan Gregory's head for ball one. If you're just joining us, the score is currently 4-0, and Greenwood has full bases with Ethan Gregory up to bat. So far, it's been a pretty lopsided game. Greenwood does have 6 hits compared to Cumberland County's 1. And after that pitch, it will be a 2-1 count now for Ethan Gregory. What have your thoughts so far on the game, Tucker?
I think Greenwood's done really well with their hitting discipline. There's been a whole lot of long at bats so far. Mm. You can tell by the high pitch count for Colby Huddleston. He's already into the 80s, and it's just the third inning.
That will even the count now to make the count 2 balls, 2 strikes.
Ooh. That almost turned south very quick.
Yeah.
Could have been another run scored. But, number 25, Bradley Sewell, wouldn't have been able to jump in front of that.
Does that – oop.
And that's another good piece of hitting by Ethan Gregory right there. Coach Jagger's going to send Drew Lohrs home, and he's going to make it easily.
I think that will be the 4th RBI there for Ethan Gregory as he will advance, and that will be a double for him. So that will be runners on 2nd and 3rd, and 6 runs scored now by Greenwood.
That's got to feel good if you're Ethan Gregory. You've been bouncing in and out of the starting lineup. Because due to some defensive errors, you've been shining on offense.
Yeah.
Some really good walk-up music. It's a Gangster's Paradise this time by Kate Thornton. Ooh, that's a far
shot
right there, but it's going to land harmlessly in the glove of Cumberland County's right fielder.
So we'll retire Kate Cameron Thornton, Patterson. And it will be the end of the 3rd now. Going to the top of the 4th, your Greenwood Gators are far and ahead with a 6-0 lead. It is senior night tonight, by the way. Our 4 seniors, Mac Osbrooks, Drew Lohrs, Chandler Wilson, and Tyler Cook are all in the starting lineup today with Mac Osbrooks on the mound. Oh, wait, no. Is there going to be a pitching change?
Looks like Drew Lohrs has switched gloves.
And there will be a pitching change. Drew Lohrs will be pitching today.
Oh, Lance Upright gave us a good old fake out. And now it's going to be Drew Lohrs on the mound.
Now on the mound for the Gators, number 22, Drew.
Drew Lors might give him the heater, or might give him the deuce. So with Drew Lors on the bump now, Chandler Wilson will be at first, and Matt Goswick will shift over to right field, and Tyler Cook will remain in left. Be on the lookout for some very creative pitching by Drew Lors. Oh, Cade Thornton is playing shortstop. Cade Thornton is playing shortstop.
Oh, he is.
Lefty shortstop.
It's an odd choice.
It may work out in the end, though. I know. Cade's not playing shortstop. Cade's still in third. Or in center field. Sorry, folks. That's my bad. Now, up to bat will be Briley Sewell, the catcher for Cumberland County.
So Wesley Flowers playing shortstop. Mac is actually no longer a fielder.
Now Drew Lors is pitching. Let's see if he gives him the hit or if he gives him the deuce. He goes for the pitch. Oh, no, I'll be just inside.
Here's the 1-0 pitch. Oh, it's going to be strike one. Good delivery there by Drew.
No man looks better on that mound than he does. Am I right, Tucker?
Sir. There's no better looking man on this baseball team.
That's a fact.
This baseball field, I'd venture to say. That's going to be into the glove of Lance Upright, and that's going to be out number one. It's been a really good fielding night for Lance. He's had a few really good plays.
So now up to bat for Cumberland County will be
Caden Stollett.
Oh, Caden Stollett, whoops. Shortstop for Cumberland County.
And he jumps on it. Good piece of hitting right there by Caden Stollett. He's going to try to run for second. Nope, he just took a hard round off.
So that will be a very long single there for him, ending Drew Lors' no-hit bid.
That's going to be Isaiah Dyer. He had a really long double his first at bat. It could have easily been a triple with his speed had it not been well fielded. Ball is gonna miss high for ball one.
Awkward silence. That'll be a far and out, far and down pitch there for Drew Lors, making the count 2-0. If you just joined us.
Delhink looked to keep him honest right there.
And if you're just joining us, the score currently is 6-0 in favor of your Greenwood Gators in the top of the fourth with a 3-0 count now for Caden Stollett.
Looks like we have some action in the Cumberland County bullpen.
Gotta so that was a pretty questionable call there by the ump, but we won't second guess him, and that will be a walk now for Drew Lors with runners on first and second. Now up to bat for Cumberland County will be Deacon Duval, the third baseman.
It's going to be ball one.
I was hugging the inside corner right there, but just barely missed it.
As it was just mentioned in the press box, that's Drew's 7 consecutive ball. That's the thing, he just wants to get one over the plate here.
I guess you could say he's just having a ball out there, Tucker.
I don't think he's having much of a ball. Oh, no. Oh, it's a fake. Okay. It got me too for a second. I was about to say, that ball went pretty far. I'm not able to track it.
Awesome. Pretty clever play there by Greenwood.
The play's pulled quite a bit at the high school level. That's going to be strike one. That's going to end his ball streak.
So that will be a ball one, or a strike one against him. So it will be one ball, one strike now for Deacon Duval. That'll be an outside pitch at the dirt now for ball two. Drew's kind of got to breathe, let the game come to him, you know?
He's not focused on trying to do too much right now. Just try to hit his spots more than anything. And that's going to land fair. And they hold the runner at third. Good job fielding right there by
Tyler
Cook.
Come on, Drew. You got this, buddy. Hey, this is where Drew performs best, though.
Under pressure.
Yeah, under pressure. Like Freddie Mercury.
And David Bowie.
Dum 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 dum
dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum
dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum dum. That'll be another pitch in the dirt now for Drew Lors, making the count 1-0. But we know he'll rebound.
Hopefully. I have faith.
We don't need hope when Drew's on the mound.
I think we do in this situation. His ball to strike ratio is pretty bad, I would venture to say. I don't have an official count.
That'll be a very questionable call there by the ump.
Really questionable ball.
That will make it count 2-0 now for Huddleston. Oh,
uh-oh,
Jesus
this
Christ.
This could be bad. Nope, Cade Thornton's able to make the catch, but will he be able to throw it home? No. And that's going to be the first run across for Cumberland County.
That will be a sack fly there for Huddleston. That will be an RBI and a run scored now. So the shutout bid will come to no fruition, and that will make the score 6-1 now. But with Greenwood still far and ahead in the lead. Tucker's having a little drinky poo. Drill holes with the pitch. It goes in. And it's cranked out of the park.
That actually could have been cranked out of the park had he not jumped on it so much.
That will be Dawson Smith, number 5. For
he gets that about a tenth of a second later, and it's probably sitting in Greenwood's bullpen right now.
Be a good off-speed pitch there by him, but that will be called a ball for the first one, making it 1-1.
Really unforgiving strike zone by this umpire, especially in this inning. That has to hurt if you're Drew.
This ump crew seems very very strict, if I do say so myself. I'll be on the outside corner, but not on the outside corner, making it 2-1.
Outside the outside corner.
The outside corner. So outside that it wasn't on the outside. It was
the
on the outside of the outside.
The outside squared corner.
That pitch was on the inside of the inside. Of the inside. Right down the middle there by Drew Lowes. That will be the second ball, so it will be 2 balls, 2 strikes, 2 outs, and 2 on.
Uh,
All right, that will be in the dirt. Oh, no.
Full count right here.
Full count and two runners on.
Gotta be careful here with your Drew.
Ooh, got him with the off-speed. Good pitch right there.
Great piece of work there by him.
Surreal. You got to feel good if you're Greenwood to get out of that inning with only one run scored.
Absolutely.
It was looking pretty bad to start it out.
But if one man can do it, it's Drew Laws.
It is. All jokes aside, though, that off-speed was
you know who
actually
this is.
Nasty.
Come on, Tucker.
Oh, shoot. Okay.
Who sings this?
I actually can't tell where this guitar riff is from.
Come on, Tucker.
Oh, this is just Def Leppard. Okay.
Yeah.
Pour Some Sugar on Love. Yeah. I couldn't tell if it was or not.
Pour some sugar. And Colby Huddleston will be at 85 pitches entering the bottom of the fourth. Is that a different pitcher? Oh,
yes.
A different pitcher.
He's Bradley Sewell. He was warming up in the bullpen in the previous inning.
So who will the new catcher be? Will be number 8, Colby Huddleston. So they did a little one-two switch there. Pulled a fast one on us.
Like a late 90s sitcom, Trading Places.
What?
I vaguely remember a TV show being named Trading Places. It's a pun.
Thanks for appealing to our 60-year-old woman audience, Tucker. No, to Bill. What
are you talking? You know what? Castle appeals to 60-year-old women, too. But that show is still pretty good, in my opinion.
It's basically like House, but just detectives.
Yes. Ooh.
I'll be a whiff right there by
Nasty
Downing.
Change up right there. Got him way out in front of it. They really stepped up in the plate so far. Delhing's got his left foot right in front of the line. Ooh.
He almost got domed for the second time this game.
Think he would have charged the mound that time?
I've always thought, what are high school coaches' policies when it comes to charging the mound?
I'm sure every coach has their own policy, but it probably is all something along the lines of, please do not charge the mound. Oh.
Oh.
Good catch right there.
Be a line drive hauled in by the third baseman there. Deacon Duvall.
The right fielder.
So fresh and so clean. Now Mac Osbrooks, the stalwart, now up to bat. Greenwood.
It's going to be taken for strike one. I'll tell you, Cumberland County is really leaving the middle of the infield wide open.
Mm-hmm.
And it's burned them a couple of times so far. Multiple 2 RBI shots have been hit right up the gap.
Both by Ethan Gregory.
Yes. Max quickly behind 0-2. Ooh, and he almost jumped onto base right there. Hadn't even hit. Ooh, he jumped on that one. That's going to land in the practice football field. Actually, the practice soccer field.
Do you know what the current batter's favorite cookies are?
What would that be?
Macaroons.
Could be macadamia nuts as well. And And that's going to be driven fair, but right at the left fielder.
So that will be for the second out now. Now up to bat will be Braxton Garner for Greenwood.
It's a couple of extra base hits that have been robbed by Garrison Bean so far. A whole lot of old school hip hop being used as walk up music. It's going to be outside for ball one.
Tucker, put your phone away. This is an important occasion. It's our last broadcast. Drop it. No, put it away. God, Tucker, you're so unprofessional.
Here's the 1-2 pitch. And it is flown straight up. Is that going to go over the net? No.
What the heck?
And he's able to make the catch. Good catch there by Colby Patterson. Not much you can do about that.
Mm-hmm.
Or Colby Huddleston. Excuse me.
So that will be Braxton Garner retired, and it now will be the top of the fifth inning for Greenwood.
Going to be Drew Lawrence still on the mound.
It could be $15. You can tell me who sings this.
Could not tell you.
Got to listen to it a little bit longer.
I honestly don't know.
Stone Temple Pilots.
Yeah. Not a big Stone Temple Pilots fan. That's probably why I wasn't able to recognize it. Now to bat is going to be number 20, Hunter Perdue. And that's going to be outside in the dirt for ball one.
Drew Lawrence has really kind of got to work on his ball placement. He's been placing his balls worse than a faulty skee ball machine. It'll be a real high pitch there for called strike one. Making the count 2-1 now for Drew Lewis.
That's going to be hit right back at Drew. He's just going to make the easy toss to Chandler Wilson. That's going to be one out in the inning.
So now up to bat will be the third baseman now for Cumberland County, Deacon Duval. A stalky individual out there.
Ooh, that went over his head.
A very, very outside pitch there by him.
Ended up landing on the WKU logo behind the plate.
That was like a Pedro Martinez versus the Yankees type pitch right there.
The That's going to be in the dirt for ball two.
These umps have been real to the number tonight, haven't they?
Yes, they have. They're really unforgiving on the edge of that strike zone.
Mm-hmm. We don't have the official numbers for how many batters have been walked, but it's been a pretty large number for both sides tonight.
That's going to be ball one or strike one here. Hopefully, Drew can battle his way back here.
Count now is 3-1.
Ooh, that's going to be inside for ball four.
So that is Ethan Gregory going out there, giving him a little pep talk, a little slap on the keister, try to get him to get his head in the game. So now there is a runner on first now for Drew Lors with who was that at bat?
It was number 15. Burger King foot lettuce, apparently, because we don't have his name on here.
That's why you put down the substitutes, Tucker.
It is number 15, Reggie. Did you say?
Reggie Barnhill.
Barnhill. I thought that was Reggie Barn the second. For a second. All right, Reggie Barnhill, first substitute of the game.
Cumberland County's fan section is, how would you say, depleted?
Well, they are 2 hours away, Jackson. I would give them the benefit of the doubt here. Now, Lance Upright turns away the double play opportunity to just get the sure out at first. It was a good idea by him.
So that will make it the second out now for Cumberland County as they, as we go deeper and deeper in this game. Right now, we're at the top of the fifth. Where it begins.
You have to think if you're at Cumberland County here, you really want to score a run in this at bat.
Now there will be a courtesy runner here at second base. He's a ginger. And we're at number 24. Drum roll, please. Ashton
Sam
Johnson.
Rice.
Nope. That's Ashton Johnson.
That's 21. You said 24.
Oh.
Sam Rice.
Sam Rice. Oh. Sorry, folks.
This lineup card is written very poorly. Ooh, that's going to be ball one.
I didn't even know they knew how to write in Cumberland County.
That's probably why it looks so bad.
I'm just kidding. I don't have any sticks against you guys. So we'll be an inside pitcher now for ball one. Make the count 1-0. And he will crack it up the middle.
And this should end the inning here for the Gators. And it will. And Drew Lors is able to keep him scoreless again. Or at least in this inning. He's held him to one run. It's a good relief appearance, if I do say so myself.
Absolutely. He's been doing pretty well. He's only given up one run so far. He has, however, given up, I think, two hits so far through this game. Or is that three hits?
More than two.
I don't know if Mac Osberg's gave up a single hit.
He gave up a few.
Well, because Drew definitely gave up two.
Yeah.
So, Drew Lors has only given up two hits in two innings so far, so he's actually been pretty effective as a RP for Greenwood. As we do come into the bottom of the fifth inning, it will be Chandler Wilson up to bat first. Then it will be Lance Upright following him up on deck.
It's a lower half of the order here for the Gators, but they've been pretty productive on offense so far.
Especially Ethan Gregory already has four RBIs in this game alone.
Yes, he's two for two with four RBIs.
I think this is Judas Priest, honestly.
No, this is Hart. This is Barracuda. One doesn't typically mix up Hart and Judas Priest.
Well, it sounded like it for a little bit there.
I mean, a little bit in the guitar. That was about it.
Have you ever listened to much Judas Priest, though?
Not really, no. I do listen to a lot of Hart, though. And that's a good piece of hitting right there by Chandler Wilson. It's going to roll fair, taking advantage of this odd infield lineup for Cumberland County.
Hit it straight into that gap there by him. That was a good piece of pull hitting there by Chandler Wilson.
So what you want to do, just get as many base runners on there as possible. Got another pinch runner right here, number 19, Webb Van Ocker. This is a sophomore for Greenwood.
Now up to bat will be the current boyfriend of Chapel Volkert, Lance Upright. That's a real outside pitch there.
Well, a question to pose of you, Jackson. Which show do you think is better? Everybody Hates Chris or Fresh Prince of Bel-Air?
Definitely Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
I actually think that Everybody Hates Chris is better by a wide margin.
Well, the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air kind of had that emotion factor to it.
Yes, it did.
I think it had a better story behind it. Everybody Hates Chris was more funny and everything like that. But
I feel like Everybody Hates Chris had more cutting satire, but
yeah. But the
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air had more emotion.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air definitely had that emotional factor to it, though. I don't think Everybody Hates Chris kind of had. Everybody Hates Chris kind of has a jokey tone just from the title.
Yeah. Especially since it's narrated by Chris Rock.
Yeah. So that will make the count 2-1 now for Lance Upright, with Briley Sewell on the mound.
Takes a good long look at his catcher and then delivers it. And Webb Van Ocker is going to easily reach second. Uh-oh. Real boneheaded move right there. And now he is out. Not quite sure why he left the bag there.
Kind of confusing.
There. Good old 2-6 pickoff right there. Not quite sure that happens a lot. And now instead of having two runners on and no out, we have one runner on and one out. That shouldn't be a problem for Drew Lores. It'll just mean it's a two-run home run instead of a three-run home run for him.
It'll just be a good slam rather than a great slam.
Yes.
Have I gone through those slam rankings with you before, Tucker?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, I don't really know what he was thinking there on that pickoff. Mm-hmm. So they're saying up, up, and then he stood up and then turned around.
Could have possibly thought that it was a foul ball, but I'm not quite sure how.
Yeah, so that will be a 2-0 now for Drew Lores.
It's got to be a big break for Cumberland County, though. These outs haven't been very easy to come by. It's another big shot by Drew Lores. Is that going to land fair?
Just barely.
There have been a bunch of really nice catches so far by Cumberland County. That time by Isaiah Dyer.
Drew Lores got straight robbed from a double on that one, though. Maybe a possible RBI for how good that one was. As we hear the sirens over the tracks.
Ooh.
That'll be a big whiff right there by Tyler Cook. Just kind of got to compose himself and get that bat around. Count 0-1.
And Lance Upright going for his second or third steal of the game, and he's going to make it.
That's a Ricky Henderson type stat right there with those three steals, isn't it?
Yep. Or I'd say Billy Hamilton.
Don't compare Ricky Henderson to Billy Hamilton. Oh, my gosh.
Well, on base running alone. Yeah.
Ricky Henderson won an MVP. Billy Hamilton is struggling to even make an MLB roster.
He's still one of the best base runners in baseball, and that was the apt comparison. Ooh, got him with the changeup right off speed right there.
So that will be the second strike for him, making it an even count at 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, two outs, and 1-on-2. Outside pitch in the dirt there as Lance Upright advances to third. So that kind of makes Tyler Cook want to choke up a little bit more probably and get that run scored.
Right.
With the full count now, though. But that's a batter's favorite count right there is 3-2. Except not in Tyler Cook's situation as he strikes out in that situation. As we advance to the top of the sixth, we'll be right back. And we're back. Now Chandler Wilson will be on the. How do I just said Chandler Mouson. We'll be Chandler Wilson now on the mound for Greenwood, and starting off early with that outside strike there.
Looks like Coach Jaggers is looking to run all of his seniors on senior night.
Which is you can kind of commend him for doing that.
Yep. Unlike the now unemployed Bob Pels.
So that will make the count now 1-2. As he tries a off-speed pitch that bounces off the top of the catcher's glove. Much emphasis on tries to throw an off-speed pitch.
Of course, I was referencing there the benching of our fan favorite, the Mass Marauder, Isaac Stansberry, on senior night. Isaac, if you're watching this, we still love you.
I think he only played like a solid 2 minutes in that entire game.
No, he played a lot against Logan County. You weren't at that game. We weren't able to
senior
broadcast
night?
It.
Talking about senior night.
Yes.
We were at
Logan
senior night.
County. That wasn't senior night. They made senior night not the last home game for whatever reason.
Huh. So after that walk, it will be Isaiah Dyer now up to bat for Cumberland County. Number 9.
Oh, he kind of halfway swung at that.
Be a funky hit right there.
And
but
it's a funky out now. But
he will be out now after Drew Lors holds that one in.
Bumper.
I've never lost a game of bumper cars. You don't wanna, you don't even want to try, Tucker. And up to bat for Cumberland County will be the absolute unit, Deacon Duval. I think it's the first game I've seen where Chandler Wilson has pitched.
Yes, I think it has been the first game that he's pitched. At least that we've streamed anyway. He's probably been on the mound before. To think you didn't play with a little bit more of a sense of urgency if you're Cumberland County. Maybe you start swinging at some of these strikes because you know you're not going to get that many more opportunities. You only have 5 more outs now.
As Duval finds himself behind now with a 0-2 count.
It's going to be another attempt at an off-speed that misses high.
Tucker, are you going to miss broadcasting with me?
Yes, I will miss broadcasting.
Wow. I said, will you miss broadcasting with me? And you said, hey, I'll miss broadcasting.
Oh, I'll miss broadcasting with you as well.
Wow. First you call Ian not your favorite scorekeeper, and then you say you're going to miss commentating without me. Gosh, man.
Epic. All right.
So that will be the second batter wave now for Chandler Wilson.
And they give a little replacement job there by Dell Hink. He grabbed the ball up in the zone and then tried to center it.
Couldn't pull a fast one on the ump on that one, though.
Sometimes you will see that, though. That umpire just misses it that split second before the catcher brings it back in. Chandler Wilson's quickly behind in the count, 2-0. And that's 3 balls now.
So it's 3 straight balls there for Chandler Wilson. He finds himself behind with a 3-0 count now.
You have to commend Colby Huddleston for some patience, though. Mm-hmm. Normally, if you're down by 5 runs with this little of the game left, you'd want to jump on everything.
Great plate discipline by avoiding those pitches, though. But he will miss that one, making it 3-1 now.
Of course, you never really want to swing at something when you're at 3-0. You don't want to give up a great count just a dribbler.
You want to go yard. 3-0, that's when you hold onto the bottom of your bat and
maybe
swing
if
that
you're
thing.
Scott Shebler.
So that will be a foul ball now, making it a full count.
We've got full count here. Chandler Wilson looking to end the inning without any runs scored.
Yeah,
And that's going to be strike three. Just barely caught the inside of the plate.
So that'll be a very effective up and down there for Chandler Wilson with only 16 pitches to wave four batters there. Or three batters there for Chandler Wilson. Faced four batters, but got three of them down.
That's four pitches a batter. That's real efficient right there.
Johnny B. Good here. Who sings this?
Honestly, could not tell you.
Do you know who? Sorry.
I could not tell you.
Chuck Berry.
Ah.
Come on, man. One of the original great blues guitarists, along with B.B. King. Hmm. You know who B.B. King is, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Chuck Berry actually composed most of Elvis Presley's music, surprisingly. It was just in the age of segregation, so Elvis Presley didn't want to have his lyrics and his music accredited to Chuck Berry until later on because of the racial stigmas against African Americans in the United States. Hmm.
Coming up to bat in this inning is going to be Ethan Gregory. Unfortunately, you won't be able to tack on any more RBIs in this at bat.
That'll be a real high pickoff attempt there by the catcher. Maybe his arm's a little rubber bandy after he just came off the mound. So this might be Greenwood's last attempt at kind of adding on to this lead for them. Try to pad their stats a little bit.
And that ball is going to go foul into the street.
Or did it get caught by the trees?
I'm not quite sure.
Might have been a foul ball robbery there by the tree.
Be outside for ball one.
That hit the ground before it even reached the batter's box.
Wasn't quite sure if that just hit the catcher's glove really weakly or if it hit the ground from my angle here.
So that will be ball number one. Make the count even at 1-1.
Ooh.
That'll be a Happy Gilmore swing there by Ethan Gregory. Way out.
Here comes the 1-2 delivery. And it's going to be strike three, but he's going to try to run it out.
He's got a slide for that one.
To the tune of Gangster's Paradise, here comes Cade Thornton.
Very good taste.
This is good taste. The O delivery to Cade Thornton. That's going to be ball one.
Tucker, this might be our last inning we ever commentate.
We have one more inning, actually.
Well, no, because this is probably the last half inning, and then they have another half inning.
Yeah.
But unless they haul off and score five straight runs, I don't know if they if we'll see a bottom of the seventh.
That's a fair point. And that's ball two.
That'll be a bouncer there by him.
Yeah,
and we just want to give a quick thank you to all 10 of our viewers.
Yeah, this is a pretty high viewer count, actually, compared to our last few games.
Nothing makes me feel more joy in my heart than you all playing this in the background while you browse through your phones. Or if you're just watching this, then we really appreciate that too.
Thanks.
Alright.
But I mean, MLB broadcasts are pretty boring. Imagine if it's a high school broadcast with two losers who don't know what they're talking about.
I'd like to think I know what I'm talking about. I'm a little bit better than Tom Brenneman.
What?
Not Marty, Tom.
Oh, I was about to say.
No.
How dare you disrespect our Lord and Savior.
Tom Brenneman is
the Reds broadcast.
Oh, man, that's a...
It's a plunk there. It's a
quick plunk right there. Didn't see us. And now we have a courtesy runner again. Or a pinch runner.
Reed Sloan. And now Mac Osbrook's up to bat. Maybe he can replicate some of his Greenwood heroics at this at bat. And crank one over the fence or just hope to get the ball in play like we know he can. Be an outside pitch there for ball one.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Jumped on that off-speed pitch.
That was a
right
whiff
there.
And a half right there.
It's got to be a good confidence booster for Riley Stuhl. Delivery. That's going to be a 2-1 count now. And that's going to be in the dirt for ball three.
Bounce off the catcher's masks on that one.
And base runners are going to advance. Now we have runners on second and third with only one out.
And with three balls on this one, Mac Osbrooks might just stand there and let this one pass by him. And
you've got two really big power hitters up to bat. You've got Mac. And he launches one into middle left center field. And that's going to be caught by Isaiah. And another run's going to be scored by Kate Thornton.
So it will be an RBI there attributed to Mac Osbrooks. A fitting end right there to his Greenwood career.
Well, it's not an end to his Greenwood career. He still has more games. This is his
regular season career.
Well, they had two more regular season games. Just
no, they
last.
Don't.
They do.
No, that's the last game.
At Franklin Simpson and at Glasgow. This is just the last home game.
Ah, okay.
Home game. Quotation marks around it, considering this is at Western Kentucky. Ooh, good hit right there by Braxton Garner. And that's going to be past the diving hands of Isaiah Dyer, and that's going to be another run
three?
Scored
can
for Greenwood.
He's not going to try to get that triple on that one.
He got the RBI, though.
So, yeah, there will be an RBI there now with Reed Sloan scoring. So now the score will be inflated up to 8-1 now in favor of the Greenwood Gators with Chandler Wilson now up to bat.
Got another pinch runner on. Would be number 10. Would be Zach Upright, younger brother Lance Upright.
He's a curly haired individual if you've ever seen that guy.
Yes, he is. A tall individual as well. Here's the 0-0 delivery. And Chandler Wilson jumps on it. It's going to go foul.
So we'll make the count now, 0-1.
Here comes the 0-1 delivery. And that's going to be a very generous strike call right there.
I think this ump just kind of wanted to get out of here. And this one as early as he can.
It was hanging up in the zone a little bit. If you're a power hitter like Chandler Wilson, you
your eyes
jump
light
on
up
that.
On that one, yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, bad cut right there.
It will be a check swing, but they will say he went around. That will be strike three now to retire the batter. So now we'll be the top of the seventh now for Cumberland County, hoping to maybe get some offense running, score 7 runs in a row, maybe. And
looks like we might have a new pitcher. Looks like we're going to have all 4 seniors pitching tonight. Tyler Cook is about to take the mound, probably to close out the game for your Gators.
I love that.
Yes, I do like that move.
Tyler Cook might be pretty loose for this game, though. But since this is our last broadcast, guys, take me out to the ball. It's 7th inning stretch, Tucker. Come on. Take me out to the crowd. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jacks. I don't care if she ever comes back, because it's root for the home team. They don't win, it's a shame. For it's 1, 2, 3 strikes, you're out at the old ball game. Bloom, boom, boom, boom.
That was pathetic.
That's our last inning we'll ever be together again. I'm going to miss you too again. Greenwood seems pretty loose right here, if you if you think.
It's like the vibes are all good in this mound meeting.
What if Tyler Cook just comes out and plunks like 11 batters in a row?
That wouldn't be good.
That would be hilarious. But that's definitely not going to happen.
And that's going to miss outside for ball one.
This is actually 2 southpaw pitchers in a row for Greenwood, with Chandler Wilson and Tyler Cook both pitching.
And that one's going to catch the outside corner. Going to be strike one. That's going to be ball two. Apparently. He's having a tough time getting that outside corner. And that one's going to get lost into the street. And it did not hit a car.
Now the count now is even at 2-2.
That's going to be strike three.
Real slow pitch there for strike three. That'll retire Dawson Smith. And now up to bat will be Hunter Perdue, the designated hitter.
Looked too happy with the umpire on that call there.
Well, that was a beautiful pitch there by Tyler Cook, if I do say so myself.
That was a good pitch. That's going to be ball one.
Tyler Cook, the resident Vampire Diaries fan.
Well, Drew Lloyd's is one as well.
So that will be strike one. I tried watching Vampire Diaries before.
Why?
I give everything a try, Tucker.
I would not give that a try.
I mean, you don't knock until you try it.
Are you knocking it now?
Yes. That show's garbage. All right, then.
Point proven.
So that outside pitch there will even the count at 2-2. So that'll be a very low pitch there. That will not be called a strike for a full count now.
And here comes a full count delivery, and that's going to be ball four.
Yep.
So now some signs of life here from this Cumberland County offense. Or I wouldn't say signs of life, maybe a few brain impulses from a previously declared brain dead patient.
Tucker, Jesus Christ. All right, now up to bat will be Curtis Akeley, the first baseman for Cumberland County. Absolute unit right there.
And that's going to be ball one. Still struggling to establish the outside part of that plate. And that's going to be ball two.
That's a real low pitch there for 2-0. Could have been, could have caught that outside corner, but like we said earlier, this referee has a very conservative strike zone.
And that's going to be strike one, right? Or strike two, actually. Or no, strike one.
If you're just joining us, the score is 8. So now the count is 2-1 now for Akeley.
And that's
pitching the dirt
be
now
wealthy.
For 3-1.
Greenwood pitchers have a really hard time establishing any part of the strike zone. Luckily, it hasn't translated to much. Cumberland County has only been able to get across one run.
And only get 3 hits. So
yeah.
They've really struggled with getting that bat around and
yep.
Getting that ball. So now it will be a full count now for Akeley.
And here's the full count delivery. Check swing, foul ball. Would have been a good check swing. It just happened to hit the bat in the process. And that's going to be a chopper ball in the infield. Wesley Flowers doesn't even look towards second. He's going to get the second out of the inning.
That was a very easy out right there.
Now we have Cameron Patterson up to bat with 2 outs. Tyler Cook looking to just end the game here and end senior night with a big W.
First pitch right down the middle there for a ball.
And called a ball, okay.
Apparently the referee is watching a different game than we are.
It's an umpire, Jackson.
That'll be a loose chopper there. Foul for strike one.
Surprised the umpire didn't call a ball on that one, too.
That'll be another foul there for strike two. I think they got 1-2. So this might be the very last pitch for Tyler Cook now to end this game.
Gets a signal from Dell. Takes a good long look at the second baseman and steps off the mound. gets back, gets the signal from Dell, looks over at second baseman, delivers, and strike three.
That'll
and that's going to be the ball game.
And this one belongs to the Gators. Well, Tucker, that was fun.
That was fun.
If you're wondering, the final score today for the Greenwood Gators was 8-1 for Greenwood. It was a pretty lopsided game today, Tucker.
Yes, it was. It's a lopsided W, though. You always like to see those, especially heading into district tournament play pretty soon.
Mm-hmm. But that will be the very last game that we get to commentate, Tucker.
Yeah.
Very kind of a bittersweet moment for us, isn't it?
Yep. Oh, well, it was a good run. We had a lot of great broadcasts, and I'm glad we got to end the last one with a W.
Mm-hmm. This will now make Greenwood's record. What was it? What did I say it was before the game? 18-10 now?
Yeah, 18-10.
Yeah, so they're going into the playoffs with a head full of steam. So, guys, this has been Jackson Sutherland.
And Tiger Clack. And Ian Shimizu.
And
Eli Lovell to some effect.
Oh, well, Ian Shimizu didn't want to say this is Ian Shimizu. But Ian Shimizu is right here. This is Jackson Sutherland, Tuck Kleck, and this is Greenwood High School TV signing off. Keep chomping.
See y'all around.
We love you. But in like a...